Agilent is excited to introduce its new user interface on its Infiniium oscilloscopes. The new user interface is designed for personalized viewing, better, faster documentation, and the best usability, including touchscreen control. As you look at this new user interface, you immediately notice that the vertical scale is displayed right on screen. The same thing can be said for the horizontal scale. This enables you to see exactly what your waveform is without actually turning on a measurement. Again, the new user interface is designed for personalized viewing. Only the vertical controls that are most important are right on display. If I wish to change them, I simply move my mouse over them and I can change the scaling of the vertical controls. Either that or I can move right into the scaling window and use the mouse wheel right on my mouse to be able to change the scales. Another thing that you'll notice is that only channel 4 is displayed. Channels 1, 2, 3, and 4, their controls are no longer available. In order to maximize your viewing area, only the channels that are enabled are turned on. To turn on different channels, you simply click on the Additional Signals button and then turn on the channels that you wish to see. The same thing can be said to turn them off. Using that same menu, you simply click on the buttons again, and now those channels which you had previously turned on are now turned off. You'll also notice a control which is the pin-unpin control. There is a lot of gray space right here which is unused. By choosing the pin-unpin control, this can now be used as waveform area, and your signal can actually display right behind these vertical scalings. You see this as I move the signal's offset until it's displayed right behind that menu. The other thing with pin-unpin is that if I wait 5 seconds, now I can truly see the entire waveform that's on display. When I move my mouse, the scaling control reappears on display. The new user interface features up to 20 measurements. The measurements are displayed right down below on your screen. If I want to use more space to see more of my measurements, I can grab the slider bar and move it up to display all of the measurements that I want to see. The new user interface also has tab viewing. By clicking in the display menu and choosing tabbed or custom window layout, I now can see my channel in a tab view and my measurements in another tab view. If I turn on additional signals, each signal gets its own waveform area. In this case, channel 4 occupies waveform area 1, and channel 1 occupies waveform area 2. The other thing with the new user interface is that I can float a tab view. To do this, I simply left-click on the tab and click Float. Now this window is its own floating window that's completely adjustable to its size and can easily be moved to another display. If I just want to see the measurement window in the top right corner, I now have the ability to do that. No other user interface in the world gives you this kind of flexibility. The final feature that we want to talk about are measurement markers. When I turn on measurement markers, their delta is automatically displayed right on screen. As I move the marker, the delta changes. This change can be seen right on screen. One other thing to note is that a handle appears right at the bottom of the screen. This handle is designed for touchscreen controls. One of the more difficult tasks of using a touchscreen control is moving a marker. However, with this handle button, it's easy to grab the marker and move it to the position you want to see it in. The new user interface is designed for personalized viewing, better, faster documentation, and the best usability, including touchscreen controls.